Hi, in this video, I will show you how to make this split screen effect that you see on famous YouTube channels on Premiere Pro. Before we dive into this tutorial, ensure you have Adobe Creative Cloud installed. If you haven't got it yet, click the link in the description to download and start your free trial today. Open Adobe Premiere Pro and create a new project. Let's give a name to our project first. Now hit Create. Once the project opens up, click on File. Then click on New and select a sequence. Select your sequence settings. Here I am using the custom FHD and frame rate, but you can choose whichever you like. And give the sequence a name and click on OK. Now click on the arrow here and select your project. Now click on this page option here and select Color Matte. Keep the default settings. This will be the same settings of your sequence and then hit OK. Now choose the white color from here, as these effects looks the best with a white background. And then press OK. Now hold and drag this color matte to your timeline. You can extend it more just by holding and pulling the end. And import the clips that you want to put into your split screen. Now here's where the main work starts. Hold and drag the first clip to your timeline. Now go to Effect Controls and scale the clip down by a little bit so that you can see a border around the clip. It will look good. Now go to this arrow sign here and click on Effects. If you don't see this box or arrow sign here, don't worry. Just go to Windows and hover over Workspaces from here. Select the Editing Workspace. You should be able to see this arrow option now. If you still don't see it, just go to Windows again, hover over Workspaces, and from here, click on Reset to Saved Layout. Now you will definitely see the arrow option. Now from this Effects section, go to the Search option and search for Crop. Now hold on Crop and drag it on to your clip. Now go to your Effect Controls and click on Crop. Now go to the scene and click on the box lines and crop the clip. Now here's a pro tip. To ensure that you are cropping it marginally, you can turn on Safety Margins, which is this double box sign. If you don't see it, click on the plus button on the right. Here you will see the Margin of Safety option. So just hold and drag it down to your toolbar. Now go to Effect Controls and reposition the clip with these parameters. And use these margins of safety to make sure you place the clip's end part exactly right in the middle of the screen. And make sure you have a border all around your clip to make it look good. Now drag the second clip on your timeline and do the exact same thing to this clip as well. Just place it on the right side. So your first clip is on the left and the second clip is on the right. And leave a little space in the middle, which will work as a border. Now go to the Effects section and type Transform on the search bar. Once you see the transform effect, hold and drag it to both of your clips one by one. Now select the first clip and go to Effect Controls. Scroll down and you will see the transform effect. There you will see an option with the name Shutter Angle. This option will add motion blur to your screen movement. So set this to 180. Now go to the position option in the transform effect and click on the clock icon on the side to add a keyframe. And with the position parameters, drag the clip down and out of your screen. Then play it for a few frames. This will determine how fast or slow will the clip slide up from under the screen. Once you are happy with the time, put another keyframe. To do this, click on the diamond option from here, and then click on the undo option on the side. This will bring back the clip to its original place, leaving you with a slide up animation. As you can see, it slides up from the bottom of the screen. Now do the exact same thing for the other clip, but here, instead of taking the clip down, take it up and out of your screen. Like this. Make sure both the clips at the same speed. So place the keyframes of both clips exactly at the same place. And there it is. You split screen animation. Now for the next one, we will do everything similar. Just this time we will make the crop from the middle. And instead of put the clips up and down, it will put it on the right and the left side. So we get a different type of animation. Now to make it more smooth, we can use a flash transition effect. This is very simple. Just create a white color mat and drag it to your timeline. Put the dissolve effect on both ends of the color mat. A shortcut to this is Control D. So just press Control plus D together. Once you see this, make the color mat shorter to a point where it looks like a quick flash and then place it exactly on the top of both the clips. And here you have it, your split screen effect. If you have liked the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.